Welcome back to my channel. So today is all about my skincare. I'm just gonna show you my skincare haul at the moment. These are all the products that I'm taking into 2021. Yes guys, I'm all about my skincare. But before I go into depth and show you these products, tell you the reasons why I'm taking them into 2021 and how they can be beneficial for you and your skincare, let me just introduce myself. My name is Tanique Campbell, aka Bougie in London, and we talk about all things bougie in skincare on this channel and all things bougie in fashion. So like, what are you waiting for? Have you liked this video? Have you subscribed? Oh wait, you have? Okay, let's get into the video. Yes, I have used these products throughout the turbulent year of 2020 because most of us were in our house and I was like, I need to get my skincare on lock. Okay, so the first type of product I want to talk about is cleansers. Now, I've struggled a lot with cleansers, but there's 6 cleansers that I'm going to take into 2021. So let's start with my morning routine. So the first cleanser that I want to show you guys is from Paula's Choice. This is the Softening Cream Cleanser. So this cleanser is a rich, creamy cleanser that thoroughly removes makeup and debris without stripping the skin. I actually use this in the morning time. I've actually said many times on the channel that I suffer from dry skin, and I've actually recently switched to using this cleanser. I was kindly gifted some things from Paula's Choice, so I will be doing a full routine and review on their products, but this literally is one of my favorite products. This has beta-glucan, which is an excellent ingredient for improving the look of redness and other signs of sensitive skin. It has some antioxidant properties and it is a skin smoothing agent. It also has chamomile flower extract, and you know that chamomile is also an antioxidant, and it is literally so good for smoothing and making the skin a lot more calmer. It also has soybean oils and sterols, and soybean is an emollient, which is a non-fragrance plant oil, and this is really helpful in making dry skin look and feel better. So yeah, like, I really love using it, and I would recommend if you have dry to very dry skin to use it. I switched this and I absolutely love this. The next cleanser, I actually don't have my hands on because I've run out. Sometimes when I want an extra glowing look, I will use the Morad Vit C cleanser. And you know, vitamin C is all about keeping the skin looking hydrated, glowing, illuminated. And when you have dry skin, sometimes it's often red, sometimes it's a little bit crusty, and vitamin C just helps to just brighten up that dull skin. So I'm currently waiting for one to come, so I can't wait to use that. And for those days that you need an extra deep cleanse in the morning, this is more of like a treat for me. I like to use the Liz Earle Cleanse and Polish Hot Cloth Cleanser. So after cleansing my face, gently put it on my face, you know, smooth it in. I wouldn't use my Foreo at this point. I actually just like to do it with my hands and just smooth in and get deep into my pores, deep into my skin, in circular motions. Leave it on for like a minute or two and then gently wipe it off with a hot cloth. It doesn't actually have to be a Liz Earle cloth, but just a gentle cotton cloth, that's what I would recommend, just to wipe it off. I absolutely love this because, as I said, I do have dry skin, and that just helped to leave the skin feeling really smooth, and it's a little treat for me. Moving on to my nighttime cleansers. If I'm wearing makeup, I like to use the Ren Clean Skincare Perfect Canvas Clean Jelly Oil Cleanser. This removes makeup, SPF, and pollution. So this is it. I love this cleanser. So at nighttime, if I'm wearing makeup, like for example, now I'm filming this video, afterwards I will use this and take off all my makeup, and it literally comes in jelly form, and then you put it on your face and it becomes like an oil substance, and it just removes all the makeup. Since I've been using it, it's just been fantastic. So once I've taken off my makeup, I will then go in with the Elemis Pro Collagen Rose Cleansing Balm. Absolutely love this. It smells divine. So I will just apply this all over my face just to get rid of the excess makeup that is still lingering. And the reason why I go in with this is just because my skin is dry and I want to just add some extra hydration. This is enriched with a blend of shea butter and sweet almond oil. So as well as removing the makeup, it brightens your skin's complexion and it eliminates the dullness and evens out your skin tone. After using this balm, your skin will be looking more radiant, youthful, and refreshed. And then to wash my face, I will use the Shiseido Complete Cleansing Microframe Cleanse and Remove Face Wash. I literally will just use 2 to 3 pumps with my Foreo and just thoroughly wash my face. The reason why I love the Shiseido Cleansing Microfoam Cleanse and Remove is because it just literally just eliminates any of the leftover makeup that is still on your face,
This is a luxurious foaming cleanser and it produces a rich, creamy lather. Honestly, whenever I use this, it just makes my skin so much more rejuvenated and it just gives my skin a silky, smooth finish. It uses Japanese pure Kirishima mineral spring water. I don't know if I butchered that, but I will write the word below because I'm so bad with pronunciations. But this mineral water aids in softening and smoothing the skin, whilst the ingredient of rice germ oil dissolves impurities. I absolutely love using this as my final cleanser just to keep my skin rejuvenated and very soft.
While we're talking about cleansers, I forgot to mention that I use this Foreo. This is the Luna Mini 2 and I actually just like apply it to my face when I'm taking off makeup or when I'm using my cleansers. It's just such a cool device and I absolutely love it. Definitely taking this one into 2021 because I've used it every day and every night. Maybe not every night, but every day at least when doing my skincare routine. When I'm taking off my makeup and cleansing my face, I also go in with these. These are the Phase Halo makeup remover pads and I love using them. I actually prefer this one because it's, I think it's a little bit thicker, but they come in a range. I thought I'd show you both of them because I do have both of them, but I do prefer this one. And when I'm using the Elemis balm, I'll just use this to take off my makeup. Absolutely love this and it just helps rather than going in with your hands. What I love about this as well is that they're reusable. It's better than using like cotton pads, so we're kind of like helping the environment. I just put them in a wash and then they're ready to use, and I've actually used this one a few times. I think I've used this one as well, but yeah, love Phase Halo. Moving on to toners, and this is probably my favorite product from Ren. I don't think I've budged for the last 2 years straight whilst using this. Apart from my creams, this is actually one of my favorite products. This is the Ren Ready Steady Glow Daily AHA Tonic. Absolutely love it. And you know what? It actually says Tonique on it. So it's definitely meant for me. And I use this every day in the morning. So this is part of my morning routine.
This toner improves skin tone and texture as it gently exfoliates and brightens your complexion. It has lactic acid and willow bark extract, which is a natural BHA. Together, these two ingredients improve the radiance and revival of your skin tone to eliminate dull surface cells and minimize the appearance of visible pores. And I know that all sounds harsh, but imagine you can use this every day without irritation and your skin will be smooth and fresh and illuminated. I just don't understand. Every time I use this toner, I just feel like after using it, my face just feels so clean, so fresh, so smooth, so bright, so illuminated. And that's what we are all about. Nobody has time for dry skin, guys. Nobody has time for dry skin. I don't know about you, but I really don't.
Okay, so then for my evening routine, I use the Pixi Glow Tonic and this has 5% glycolic acid. I absolutely love this. I have used other toners for my evening routine. Obviously, sometimes my skin is a little bit more sensitive, it's a little bit more dry. I might use a different toner. Pixi do have like different ones, like a rose tonic. They have a milky tonic, which I also like. But actually, I always keep on going back to this. It's even personalized, it says my name.
Did you see the personalization? I love that from Pixi. That is so cute because this was kindly gifted. But yeah, I really like that product. This toner brightens and refines your complexion. It is an exfoliating face toner that exfoliates and purifies to promote smoother looking, radiant and clarified skin. Formulated with 5% glycolic acid and a blend of aloe vera and ginseng and botanical extracts, this toner eliminates excess oil and impurities to leave the pores looking refined and the skin's texture looking smooth and radiant.
So it's nearly finished and I think there's a new one on the way, but I also do use this replenishing multi-acid peel from Morad. I don't use it every day. It's just like when my skin feels a little bit uneven or it's a little bit higgy or it's a little bit heather, which it does tend to happen, I will go in and use this. But because it's a multi-acid peel, I don't know, like I don't use it all the time. I use it as and when it's needed, maybe once a week or sometimes even every 2 weeks, sometimes even once a month. It is quite strong, that's the thing, and I do have dry skin, so I don't tend to use it as much. I think maybe someone with oily skin or combination skin might use it a little bit more, but when it comes to acid peels, I don't really like to go in that much with it. But I thought I'd mention it because I definitely am going to be using this in 2021 because your skin does feel completely different after using it. I have heard some people say that your skin does feel a little bit sore, but I do think as long as you moisturize and use the right serums afterwards, your skin is fine.
So this actually has two phases to it. So phase one resurfaces your skin for smoother, brighter skin, and phase 2 nourishes for a more vibrant complexion. I love using this product because I feel like it's a solution for dull, rough texture and uneven skin tone.
Moving on to eye creams. So as I'm getting a little bit older, I feel like the one way to tell someone's age is with their hands and also by their eyes. So in the morning, I use the Glam Glow Bright Eyes. This is an illuminating anti-fatigue eye cream. I've been using it for a while. I have used other several brands, which I think I've spoken about on my channel. However, I just find that this one is just so calming on the eye and it just doesn't irritate me. Especially in the winter, my eyes get very irritated. But yeah, I've been using this for a while and I just stick to it because it just works.
So this illuminating eye cream is infused with brightening peptides and caffeine to enrich, energize, depuff and reduce the appearance of dark circles. Hyaluronic acid attracts up to 100 times its weight in water to intensely moisturize the under eyes and reduce the appearance of dehydration lines. Glam Glow actually did a consumer study on 107 women after one use, and 76% of these women said it instantly revived the look of tired eyes. 93% said it created a smooth canvas for eye makeup application, and 79% said it improved the look of concealer.
For my nighttime eye serum, I use the Pink Diamond Rhodial Lip and Eye Filler.
And probably my most favorite thing about this product is the applicator. It's just so soothing to put on the eyes. Absolutely love this. Rhodial say the diamond powder leaves the skin looking radiant and glowing, with fine lines visually smoothed. Hyaluronic filling spares instantly visually plump and fill the eye for a youthful appearance.
Okay, in terms of serums, for my morning routine, I like to take the Morad Vita-C Glycolic Brightening Serum. And to be honest, for the longest time, nothing has been able to replace this. So yeah, I'm just gonna stick to it.
The reason why I love this serum is because this serum is designed to fight the effects of anti-oxidative stress, targeting areas of hyperpigmentation, dullness, and uneven skin tone to promote a bright and balanced complexion. The ingredient of glycolic acid aids as an exfoliating agent, gently buffing away the top layer of dead skin cells to unearth glowy, healthy looking skin. This serum also has gold stabilized vitamin C, which enhances L-ascorbic acid stabilization and potency to brighten the skin. 83% saw brighter, more radiant skin after 4 weeks of using this serum. I absolutely love using this serum because I just feel like it gives me a brighter glow. And you know me, guys, I like my skin to be illuminated. I also find when I don't use this serum, maybe I'm in a rush or whatever, my skin does look dull. And you can definitely notice the difference.
I also like to go over the top with this Paula's Choice C15 Super Booster, which is for all skin types. This has 15% vitamin C and vitamin E with ferulic acid. Now, I've only recently started using this, but wow, what an amazing product.
This product gives a healthy dose of vitamin C for brighter, more radiant skin. It diminishes visible signs of aging for smoother, brighter, and firmer feeling skin. This formula contains 15% of vitamin C, stabilized vitamin C, and powerful antioxidants including vitamin E and ferulic acid. Skin is protected from environmental damage, and you will drastically see younger and more radiant skin day after day. Guys, did you hear that? Younger and more radiant skin. Let me get an amen for the people that are getting over 30 or 40 or 50 or 60 or 70 or even past that.
And then at night, I only use one serum, and I've been using this serum for ages, but this is the Retinol Youth Renewal Serum from Morad. And obviously at nighttime, I love to use a little bit of Retinol Curl because we gotta keep our skin in shape.
This serum is a fast-acting retinoid, a time-release retinol and retinol booster that helps fight lines, deep wrinkles, and even the skin tone and boost radiance. This serum will also aid in minimizing the signs of aging. And why I love it is because even though it has retinol and hyaluronic acid, it has actually been tested safe for sensitive skin. Whilst testing, Morad said that 93% of people saw a reduction in lines and wrinkles within just 2 weeks.
Okay. And then anytime I get a spot, I will use the Ren Clear Calm Non-Drying Spot Treatment. I just love this because I literally just put it on a spot and bada bing, bada bom, the spot is gone. Rhymes, lyrics. But yeah, I've been using this for years and it's just amazing.
Use willow bark to naturally reduce redness and the spot size without leaving your skin feeling flaky. Maritime pine and thyme work to help repair and minimize redness.
Okay, so cream. So my daily moisturizing cream that I use every day is L'Occitane Immortal Divine Cream. I absolutely love this. They've actually revamped this cream. I did a whole video when this cream was revamped and relaunched. I'll leave it somewhere here above. But this has actually been one of my favorite creams for years. Like, I've used it so much. Even before I partnered with them, I did a whole video of me using the products. And it's just so crazy that I'm still using it to this day. But yeah, it's my favorite. I even want to quickly show you because I've got a mini travel one, which I think is so cute. Let me show it to you guys.
How cute is this, my little baby moisturizing travel cream? But yeah, let me actually go into the benefits of this cream before you guys cuss me. I love applying this cream because it literally feels like cashmere in your hands. It's like a cashmere-like texture. This cream harnesses the power of 600 immortal flowers and their exceptional everlasting longevity. And this aids to correct the visible signs of aging. One main ingredient of this cream is the Immortal Super Extract, which is a gentle 100% natural alternative to retinol. It supports the skin's architecture and helps increase in the skin's density. It also aids in boosting collagen, resulting in your skin being more renewed and a thicker epidermis. Whilst the Immortal Essential Oil is a natural antioxidant which is 2 times more powerful than vitamin E, which means that your skin is going to be protected from external factors such as pollution.
Okay, and then for my nighttime, I like to use the La Mer Moisturizing Soft Cream. La Mer is renowned for its luxury skincare, so it's like, we all want a piece of La Mer, baby. But we cannot lie, it's a little bit on the pricey side. So sometimes it's like, why should you invest in La Mer? Let me tell you guys.
This is an ultra soft cream, which deeply replenishes your skin for a beautiful, glowing radiance. Your skin will naturally appear more vibrant and restored to its healthiest looking center. La Mer is renowned for its Patent Miracle Broth, which is their legendary renewing elixir that flows throughout all La Mer products. This elixir infuses the skin with sea source renewing energies. And the reason why I opt to go for the moisturizing soft cream is because this is an ideal combination for dry skin.
So I'm only showing you this because it's winter and I probably will be using it anyway throughout spring and sometimes in summer because I do live in the UK. London, baby, but yeah, it's always raining here even in the summer, so I do tend to reach for this. So because I have dry skin, I actually do have to go in with another moisturizer just because I need my skin to be staying supple throughout the night. So this is the Ren Skincare Ever Calm Overnight Recovery Balm. This is also great for sensitive skin.
This recovery balm is a rich night balm that feeds your skin with lipids from olive, almond, borage, and linseed oils. These have been activated to easily absorb into your skin to intensely nourish and moisturize your skin while you sleep. This is because when you're sleeping, your skin is going through a regenerative process that takes place.
Okay, facial oils. As you can see, I'm literally running out of this one. So if I'm not wearing makeup, I will put on a facial oil every day. When I am wearing makeup, I tend to not put on a facial oil. It's so weird. I have dry skin, but then when I put on makeup, my makeup does get oily. It's just whatever. I did use it this morning. Does my face look oily? I don't know. This is the L'Occitane Immortal Divine Youth Oil. Absolutely love this. Has a facial oil in the AM. As mentioned when I was showing you the cream, I had partnered with them. I really like the brand. And I like the efforts that they're doing to be a little bit more sustainable, thinking about the environment. They did like a huge campaign recently. So I'm very proud to be a part of the brand. I really like the brand.
This facial oil aids in fighting against visible signs of aging, aiding in preventing wrinkles, lack of firmness of skin, signs of lack of radiance, and unevenness. As mentioned before in the Divine Cream, this oil also includes the Immortal Super Extract and the Immortal Essential Oil. And the third ingredient it includes is the oily Immortal extracts, which is enriched with omega 9 and 6. Using this facial oil daily, your skin will appear more nourished and firmer. Wrinkles will reduce over time and your complexion will look brighter and more evenly toned.
Is the Pixie Jasmine Oil Blend. Since it's come out, I've literally stuck to it. Although I am going to be testing out the ordinary rosehip oil because I think rosehip oil has amazing benefits. So I'm kind of cheating. But
formulated with a cocktail of jasmine flower extract, evening primrose, and grapeseed oil, this facial oil aids in healing and calming the skin. It is rich in omega-6 oil and the antioxidant vitamin C. This oil blend will ensure that dull, thirsty skin receives a healthy dose of hydration to help revive a healthy glow. Listen, I heard thirsty skin, and you know my skin is thirsty. I'm not even gonna lie about that. So definitely love this Pixi product.
For my lip products, I use all three, to be honest, because my lips get very dry. So the first thing when I'm applying my makeup is the Pixi Vitamin C Lip Brightener. I just think that this helps to brighten up the lips and smooth the lips. But at the same time, I feel like after applying this, I still need to use another product. And that's where my handy Calmex comes in. I use this for when I'm on the go. It's a moisturizing lip balm and it's great to fit into your bag. Even though I seem to carry the tiniest bags, it still fits into there. And finally, I also use the Elizabeth Arden 8-Hour Cream Skin Protectant. And I always use this every night on my lips and I wake up with smooth, soft lips. You can also go in and apply this cream in areas that you find a little bit dry. In the winter months, I usually put it on like my knees, my elbows, and this just works magic. I'm not gonna lie though, the smell, I don't know, they need to fix that. But maybe it's because if they fix it, it won't be as potent, I don't know. But the smell is a little bit like old granny smell, and it smells just not really bougie for me. But those are the lip creams that I'm taking into 2021. Okay, now SPF, how can I forget SPF? To be honest, I'm not gonna lie to you, like there's not, I don't know where the SPF went. Okay, I'm back. In terms of SPF, I use two. I've been using the same two for years and I just haven't changed because there's no need to. I mean, I don't really need to go in detail about SPF. You just need to wear it every day to protect your skin from the sun. Like, you don't want to have sun damage. You don't want that to lead to other skin complications. The Murad City Skin Age Defense Broad Spectrum SPF 50. And this is just great for every day. And it also protects you from like the pollution that's in the air. And we get a lot of it in London. It's also a mineral sunscreen. Then I like to use La Roche-Posay because it is a tinted SPF. So when I don't want to wear makeup, then I'll use this one. It gives my face just a little bit of that extra glow. So that's why I swap between the two. Okay, facial mist. I love using the La Roche-Posay one. This is the Thermal Spring Water for sensitive skin. It calms and reduces skin irritation. I use this when I want to give my skin a little bit of a top up, a little bit of refresh. So I can use this throughout the day, on the go, even when I'm at home. Right now we're in a lockdown and my skin does get dehydrated, so I'm just like, and it's hydrated and it's no longer thirsty. The second one that I like to use is the L'Occitane Essential Water, and I use this at night. I just feel like when I spray it over all my skincare, it just makes my skin look a little bit more refreshed, refined, and I absolutely love it. Okay, and then when I wanna prime my skin, this is the Arborian Pink Primer and Care. I actually did a campaign with them a while back. If you wanna see that, it will be somewhere above here, but I absolutely love this product. It literally blurs your pores, smooths your skin out. So after I've done all my skincare, I actually use this as a primer. Can you see how my skin looks so flawless and glowing? This is one of the tricks, baby. But it's still hydrating, that, you know, it could also fall into the bracket of skincare. Especially when I'm not wearing makeup and I want to look flawless, this is what I use. Then I also have this mini one where, and it's like a blur stick. So when you're on the go, when you're out and about, oh, I think it's a little bit brown. Let's just close that. Let's just close it up real quick. But when you're out and about and you're on the go, obviously I'm not going to carry this, just a quick touch up here and there, blurring those lines, baby, blurring those lines. And someone was like to me, it's like, what does it do? And I was like, it's just like a blur. And they were like, but like what? And I'm like, I don't know, do you not understand blur? As in blur your lines out. I just don't understand. That's the only way to describe it. It's a blur stick. It blurs your lines out. Okay, so going on to the mask. There's probably about 5 masks I use. I've only got 3 of them at the moment. So I'll show you the other ones, but I won't go into detail because I don't have them. My number one favorite is the Glam Glow Flash Mud Brightening Treatment. This is it. Absolutely love it. I've been using it for ages. I actually do have a whole video on it and I will link that above. So I mask about 3 times a week to once every week. It really just depends on how my skin is behaving. And sometimes I don't even put it on my whole face because it doesn't need to be on your whole face. Sometimes you might just have a problem area and you might just want to touch up a few spots. This is my absolute favorite and it just aids in brightening and illuminating the skin, which is what I love. This is what we're here for, baby. No one wants to have dry, ashy skin. I mean, I don't know about you guys, but I don't. The second one that I use is also from Glam Glow. It's the Super Mud Clearing Treatment. I recently did like a Christmas night in with Glam Glow and they gifted me their mask, and this is like my second favorite. I still need to try out the others and see like how I get on, but absolutely love this. So I thought I would show this to you guys. It really aids in clearing up the skin when you have problem areas, and it just makes the skin like super smooth and closes those pores. Thirdly, we have the Shiseido Purifying Peel Off Mask. Honestly, like when I put this on my skin, my skin feels so soft. I actually did like a whole video about their skincare products. I'll leave it above. Their skincare products, guys, don't sleep on them. They have a little bit of luxury. I really like the brand. It's just so luxury and your skin just feels super soft when you use their products. The reason why I love this mask is obviously it does make my skin feel super soft, but it's just so fun to play with. That's all I really have to say, because that's why I like using the mask. It's just like very novelty. It's pink. It smells kind of okay. And it's just fun to play with. I don't know if that's the real reason to keep it in 2021, but we can keep it. The Body Shop have this oatmeal mask, which I think is absolutely amazing. Anytime I break out, anytime my skin is just like looking higgy hagger, I use this mask. So for those of you who are suffering from breakout spots, I would recommend using this because it literally just calms the skin. Oatmeal, oats, is known for calming the skin down, so I would definitely recommend that. The second one I would definitely recommend is the La Mer sheet mask. I think that these are absolutely amazing. Like, I did a whole video where I put it on, and listen guys, my skin was looking beautiful. So I need to buy back into those, but they're a little bit on the pricey side. But if you want good skin, gotta fork out their money. So those are the two masks that I would definitely recommend as well. Finally, bronzing products. Now, the two that I've been using in 2020 is first the MAC Body Lotion. This came out of their bronze range, so I don't actually know if this is still available. Like, I don't know if it was a limited edition or not, but this is the one that I have been using. I've also been using the Nip and Fab one, but I don't know if I left it in LA. I can't find it. I don't know where it is, but I also used that one. That one is beautiful. This is more though, I think, like I can wear this now. The Nip and Fab one, in the summer your legs will be glistening because the sun reflects. And I just realized I'm holding up MAC, but I can't find the Nip and Fab one. And then on my face I use the Duval's Argan Bronzing Oil. Absolutely love this. I've been using it all last year on my face. I can't believe there's still quite a lot. They also do cold press argan oil, and it's all kind of natural. But yeah, the brand reached out to me. I really like their products. Oh my god, guys, I feel like that was the longest video ever. But yeah, what are your favorites? Do you agree with me? Do you think I've missed out on any? Like, I don't know, what products are you bringing into 2021? Comment down below, because I would love to know. And also, I do have a little bit of FOMO. Is it FOMO? Fear of missing out. Yeah, I do have a little bit of FOMO when it comes to skincare, because I'm like, oh my god, how come you know about this and I don't know about this, and you know about this but I don't know about this, but you know about this and I don't, you get the picture. But yeah, I do have a little bit of FOMO when it comes to skincare, so I'm like, guys, tell me if I'm missing out on anything. Anyway, I'm rambling on and it's time to end the video. If you like that video, why not give it a thumbs up? If you think anyone can benefit from this video, I'll be happy to share this video. As always, I'll leave my social media platforms down below, so please follow me on Instagram, TikTok and all that jazz. But I guess I'll see you in another video, and remember to what? Always stay bougie, guys. Bye.